I am finally giving this steak a chance. Was it worth trying it? Can coffee and steak really work well together? I love steak. I love coffee. I've been thinking about this dish for a couple of weeks now, and today I'm doing it. There are a ton of recipes across the internet, but I've come up with my own to bring this dish alive. And when we get to the end, I hope that we have a fantastic dish that we can add to our cooking arsenal. Let's cook! I'll start by patting my steaks dry, and then I'll season it with salt about 1 hour before cooking. I like to let the salt go into my steak to season it well. I'm using a picanha steak today, one of my favorite cuts. And as obviously, I will be looking for a medium rare steak. Just before I cook, I make sure I pat dry my steak again to make sure I get a good caramelization on the meat. I'll add some oil into the pan, and when it's hot, I'll start by caramelizing the exterior fat on the steak. I'll hold it here for a little bit, and when it's nice and brown, I'll start cooking my steak. I like to flip my steaks every 30 seconds into the free areas of the pan that will be hotter, and I'll do this for about 2 to 3 minutes, depending on how thick your steak is. You can always use a thermometer to check the temperature of your steak to make sure you're not overcooking it. Looking good, been around 2.5 minutes, I'm removing the steaks from the pan, and while they rest, we're gonna start our pan sauce. The espresso shot goes in, and we're gonna let it reduce for a little bit. I'm gonna add the whiskey, and I'm gonna burn the alcohol. If you can't flambe it, just cook it for a couple of minutes to evaporate all the alcohol in the whiskey. Coffee and whiskey work really well together. Subscribe to the channel for more delicious recipes like this one. I'm adding sugar to balance the bitterness of the coffee, and remember to scrape the pan well to get all that flavor into the sauce. When the sauce have a nice consistency, I will add garlic powder, onion powder, garlic paste, bay leaf, mustard, and chili flakes. Mix everything well to cook all the spices in it. I'll add the double cream and a couple little cubes of butter to help emulsify the sauce. I'll taste to adjust seasoning. Mmm, delicious. And to finish it off, I will add some lemon juice. Now with a sauce that smells this good, I need some bread to dunk in it. Get a couple of slices of bread. I'm using a sourdough bread, but you can use just your favorite bread, really. It's all about what you love to eat. I'll slice my steak and I'll drown it in the sauce. To add some texture to it, I will put some crispy onions over it, but this is completely optional. And it looks beautiful. Time to taste. Let's see if it was worth trying it. Was it worth trying it? Definitely. It's really good. It's different than many other sauces that I had before. It's deep down. It's not like bright and full of energy. It's hard to put it into words, but it's just deep. It's like, feels like a winter sauce, but definitely good. Forgot something. Dip the bread. Oh yeah. The steak is well cooked, the sauce is incredible, it's a win! But the sauce is very complex. So many things going on there. You can definitely taste the coffee, makes it really, really deep. I think the sugar helped out with the balance a lot, otherwise it would be too strong. But in the end, we just found out coffee and steak work. Spicy, creamy, everything that we love in a good dish. I call this a success, but I'm a bit biased, because I love beef. But I also know everybody loves pork. And if you want to make the most incredible pork steak sandwich, just watch this video here. It will take your sandwich game to another level. Don't watch at your own peril. And I'll see you soon. Bye.